bike, please do not never ever get them a two stroke. Make sure you get them a four stroke. You may be like, what the heck is a two stroke? What the heck is a four stroke? Two strokes have a big old pipe right here, and they crazy. They're really, really crazy. They will throw you off the bike with no problem. Four strokes, they will throw you off with no problem, but they're not that aggressive until you get up to the higher CCs. Two strokes, the lower the CC, the more aggressive the bike is. So like, this is a 125. If you ever buy your child a two stroke, please put them in the grass where there's a whole bunch of grass, and make sure you buy them the correct proper gear so they don't hurt themselves too bad, because they will get hurt. I know for a fact they will get hurt, but I got hurt plenty of times riding these bikes. These bikes are not crazy machines. They don't kill people. What kills people is being ignorant and not learning the bike, not learning what you're dealing with. This is a machine. It doesn't have a mind. You're the one who's operating it. So make sure you pay attention, do everything correctly the first time so you don't have consequences after. So basically what I'm trying to say, the lower the CCs on a two stroke, let's say for like 65 CC, let's say you have like a 8-year-old son that wants to get into motocross riding, please, I'm warning you, please do not get them a 65 or a 50 CC. You can get them a Chinese 50 CC little two stroke dirt bike that's like this small, that only goes like 30 miles an hour. They can learn on that, but please do not get them a two stroke. I'm telling you, because I know I've seen people, children get on two strokes. These bikes lift up with no problem. Like, the smaller the CC, the more snappy and aggressive they are. Like, the big bikes, don't get me wrong, this bike will definitely leave the smaller bike with no problem, but it's not about that. It's about how aggressive the bike is. If anything, I would suggest them getting on the bike with you if you ever do purchase a two-stroke bike for them, like a 65, a 85, a 100, a 125 like mine's is, a 250, 500. Of course, nobody is going to teach their child to ride anything that's above 85 cc's if they're like 10 years old or younger, or maybe older, but it depends. Please get them a four-stroke to start on, because these two-strokes, they're not forgiving bikes. They don't have engine braking. And engine braking is something that you need to learn to actually ride these bikes. You need torque, you need engine braking, and you need to learn how to balance on these bikes, because they're basically like a regular bicycle. Only thing you have that's different is an engine. And most of the motocross bikes, not all of them, but most of them have a manual transmission. So manual transmission, if you're driving a manual car, it's basically almost the same thing. It's just where the placement of the clutch is. Basically, the clutch is right here, your hand clutch, pull it in, and then the clutch is on the right side. On my Honda, is on this side inside of the engine. So when you pull in the clutch, you can shift down. The transmission on this bike is one down and four up. It's a 5-gear engine. So basically, please do not get your child something that they will hurt themselves severely bad on. Start them on a four stroke, a 50 cc four stroke. It's not going to be that aggressive. It's going to have some pull to it that they have to get used to. It's going to go kind of fast, but you can govern it to make it go slower or faster. But just watch them, get them the proper gear, get them arm riding gear, leg, back, neck. Of course, they're just starting, but you want them to have that just in case they fall, so they don't hurt themselves very, very bad. So even if they're in the grass, it don't matter, but get them something that they can enjoy and something that they will feel comfortable on. I actually suggest getting them, your kids, if you want them to start off a motocross, or if they want to start off a motocross. A lot of people may be like, nah, but get them, I would actually suggest you getting them a little Razor dirt bike, the little Razor electric dirt bikes. Get them one of those and let them grow from there. You can, after they're done and after they done beat up the machine or have not beat up machine, sell it, get the money's worth from it, and then put it towards another bike. Buy them a little four stroke. Please, again, thank you all for watching the video. I hope you like. Please do not let your kids, or don't let your kids influence you to get them a two-stroke, because these bikes, well, actually at a younger age, don't worry about if they have never rode in a bike before, because I never, when I first started riding bikes, yeah, you're gonna mess up, you're gonna do all this, you're gonna do stupid stuff, crazy stuff, you gotta learn from it. But it's all a process. You gotta learn from your mistakes, like anything in life. But make sure you get them something that they can manage, something that you won't be too crazy and too scared for them to getting hurt. Once they get comfortable on the bikes, once you jump on one bike, you will not want to get off of it. I already know, because that's how it was. That's how everybody is once they get on a motorcycle. Any type of motorcycle, Harley, motocross bike like mine is, sports bike, they will tell you, unless they got in a really, really bad accident, please, get your child something that they can manage, something that they can handle. Do not get them something that's way overpowered. You know that's too powerful. So start off with a 50cc Honda or the Yamaha. I hate Yamaha, but I love Honda because of the layout that Honda has. It's very, very reliable bike. These bikes are very, very reliable. Unlike all the other Japanese and European bikes there is. I know a lot of people were arguing with me, nah, that's not true. But basically, it is. You just have to do your research, and then let me know what y'all talking about if y'all say it's not true. But basically, I'm done. So thank you all for watching this video. Hope you like, please subscribe. Peace.